It's fair to say that Freud has been fairly heavily criticised for his theories about personality. One of the major criticisms is that his theories are largely a product of the Victorian era. At the time Freud proposed these theories, it wasn't polite for people to speak about sexual things. Freud's theories actually gave people a socially acceptable way to talk about sexuality by giving sexual interpretations to everyday behaviours. Freud's theories were actually really important from that perspective because sexuality was something that hadn't been given much weight in how we understood human behaviour up to that point. Sexual development and sexuality is actually an important part of psychology, in understanding people's behaviour and clinical problems too. Freud was really the one who put the spotlight on this. Unfortunately, though, there's no evidence to support the specifics of Freud's thinking about sexuality. He's also been criticised for being sexist. For example, he thought one of the existential challenges for women was realising they're inferior to men because they don't have a penis. Well, Freud thought that the problem was, once women realised they don't have a penis, which was what made men superior, the only way for women to overcome this threat to their psyche and deal with it was by having a male child. By having a baby with a penis, the woman had produced a penis. Therefore, she would have reconciled the conflict. But there was never any real evidence that women feel inferior because they don't have a penis, or that they will feel better once they have a male child. There was also very little evidence for the presence of defence mechanisms. There is, however, lots of evidence for the unconscious, but this doesn't seem to be what Freud thought it was. So, the biggest problem with Freud's theory is that there's very limited evidence supporting it. What evidence there is comes from case studies. Now, case studies are not good at giving you conclusive evidence about causal relations between things. They're descriptive in terms of what they can tell you, but they have problems with being subjective in their interpretation. With Freud's theories, you can boil the criticisms down to the fact that they're largely not falsifiable. They're almost impossible to test systematically because Freud often predicted all possible outcomes and adapted his interpretation accordingly. For example, one of Freud's theories for why people might experience anxiety is because they're secretly in love with their opposite sex parent, and they want to murder the same sex parent and take their place. Now, which of you watching this video is secretly in love with your opposite sex parent and wants to murder the same sex parent to take their place? Anyone? Now, if most people say no, is that evidence against Freud's theory? Well, if you said yes, I really do love my mum and I want to kill my dad and take his place, that would be evidence for Freud's theory. If you said, don't be stupid, that's an idiotic idea, Freud would say, that's repression. So no matter what the outcome, there would be support for Freud's theories. This is what makes it particularly difficult to test. Now, despite the criticisms, there are still a lot of people who practice psychodynamic-based therapy and do research on it. There are people who still train people in psychodynamic theory and therapy, and some people still find it useful as therapy. Despite the problems with testing his theories, Freud's ideas have had a significant influence on psychological theory and treatment in clinical settings. Many others have expanded and modified his original ideas in new directions. Freud made major contributions in highlighting the role of the unconscious part of our minds and also the importance of sexuality in our lives.